some wine. Sit down in the chair, let me just blow your mind. A piece of cake, maybe followed by a bottle of wine. Take it easy, cut tonight, we got a lot of time. I ain't going nowhere, baby, take off your clothes. Going.
Mwamfunishe kubupina, mwamfunishe ukwabule chibote, mwamfunishe.
Hello YouTube, my name is Tomachubi and welcome to my channel. Today we have a little special something for you guys. We're actually going to show you guys how to brew an all-grain brew. So what that means is that my buddy called me and he wants to brew a beer. So he said that he's going to get all the ingredients, the grain, the hops, the yeast, everything that we need to brew. And typically we brew about 6.5 gallons. So this is our brew pot. This is the brew pot. For 2 weeks in the fermenter,
you guys all.
Thomas, what's going on here?
Oh, dude, I just got everything. I got the 6.5 gallon. I got a bunch of water. I got my fermenting vessel here.
Dude, this is all you need. Best beer in the world, right here, straight from Africa. All you need is this beer and lukewarm water. Wait, what about all this? No. Get that stuff out of here. We got this is all you need right here. You need beer powder for smooth and creamy home brew.
Wow.
Today, drink tomorrow.
In 24 hours?
24-hour beer, right here, buddy.
Dude, that's rad.
So we need this.
We need a smaller little stovetop.
I did bring one. No. Oh, yeah, we do need. Well, I guess that'll work.
Yeah, we need a little pen. I can't use that 6.5 gallon. Perfect. All right, so first thing is we're going to get...
So here, we're going to go through this. So this is what it says. It says mix the contents with 5 liters of lukewarm water.
Kupa ti lao 5 liter something.
Nangirzal.
I'm not really sure what's going on here, but this is from Africa. So after we add the contents to 5 liters of lukewarm water, we stir well, do not cook. Allow the brew to ferment for 24 hours.
24 hours. That's it. Okay, so we're on some lukewarm water here.
Okay, let me get the water.
Dude, that's gnarly. That's all we need, just lukewarm water.
Lukewarm water. That's it.
And then we're gonna put it in this.
And hopefully we have enough room. 5 liters is gonna come to about there. Hopefully we don't get much foamage. You never know.
So, does this need to be sealed at all?
I don't know. We're actually gonna put a cloth over it like kombucha.
Okay.
But anyways, I wanna go back to you. So my buddy, Andrew McKee? From where I work, he's the captain of the research ship I work on, brought me this. Actually, we traded video for this.
Oh, so that's a authentic African beer.
This is authentic African beer. They had some.
That came from all the way from Africa.
From Africa, in a bag on an airplane.
This
bag was $1.
$1.
$1 for 5 liters of beer. Quality stuff here. Anyways,
so it says beer powder, smooth and creamy homebrew. Yeah, that's pretty cool.
750 grams.
So these are some of the ingredients that are in this. And this says I don't know what this says.
I don't either. But apparently you can drink it right from the jug. You don't need
drink
to
drink it right from the jar. Get a little close up on that.
Here, Miley, come in on this. Like, right? You can drink it right from the jug. No glasses needed.
Oh, and everything. everybody's had as a drum circle. Okay, so we're just boiling water here. Now, lukewarm.
Lukewarm. What is lukewarm, anyways? I'm going to have to Google what is lukewarm because, you know.
So I'm gonna do some more water, okay, Ryan?
Sure.
And we'll boil this, and then we'll put
moderately warm. So that's basically just over room temperature, let's say.
That's like body temp.
Yeah, 98 degrees or so, probably.
So we'll boil this down. We'll boil this. Throw it in there.
Or not boil it, but just get it to where it's like hot.
Okay.
But not boiling.
I need a beer.
You need a beer.
Or we could just keep
cheers.
It
so this is a homebrew that Thomas made.
Oh yeah.
A brown ale. It's good.
Yeah, it's a hazelnut brown ale. That's the color on it. It's a little hazy.
It might be as good as our 24-hour beer. We'll find out.
That's going to be really good.
So what do you think of that this summer lager?
This is a Lagunitas.
I know, but I mean,
limited release summer lager, and it's, when you think of a lager, you think of like something like that's really light
and crispy. It's pretty much a pale ale.
Yeah, this is a pale ale. This is definitely a pale ale. This isn't a lager.
Yeah, definitely Lagunitas. A pale ale. Absolutely.
I don't know what's going on there, but
I know. Well, you know, this is what I think. I think that they tried to make a pale ale that was crummy. Now they're going to market it as a summer lager, and they'll never have to make it again.
Yeah. Limited release.
Limited release, that's it. One time, batch bad, boom, let's call it a lager.
Yeah, you nailed it. Hmm.
All right. So since while we're getting the lukewarm water ready, we'll go ahead and pour some water in here. So that we don't put hot water right in the container.
The glass, because it'll crack it, right?
If it's boiling, it could crack it. Yeah. But if it's lukewarm, it'll probably be okay. Oh, but I got to figure out. I think we're just gonna eyeball the 5 liters. I might be a little bit less. I might give myself a little bit of extra room. If it's 4 3/4, it'll probably be okay. Boom, boom, boom. I think that's all we're going to need for warm water. Right?
Yeah. We can add the rest later, but just enough to cool that.
The other thing that we're also using that's really good when you're brewing any kind of beer is spring water. And so you want to use spring water because it's got the minerals that will make the beer taste better. So you don't want like distilled, or not distilled, but what's the other one? It is distilled, right?
Where it's purified.
Purified, where all the minerals are taken out. You want spring water.
Right.
And actually the best thing that you could do is get a one of those carbon filters and straight from your sink is what I was reading. Is that you could get one of those carbon filters and get straight from your sink, and that's, you know, that's just as good as that.
So how we doing? I think that's good. I think it's good.
Okay, so just pour it in.
Yeah.
Oh, but
yeah, so we want to add that to this.
Lukewarm,
right?
And then we'll mix it.
Right, so add that to it, we'll test it, and then we'll see if we need to actually warm up any more water.
Okay, so I'll do
that. So we'll add this. We have one saucepan full right now. We're going to add this to the 2 liters that we put in here right now, and we'll see if we're at lukewarm.
Okay. Yummy. Pale ale, not a lager.
Ready? I'm gonna move this. Just in case. Oh, look at this.
With the tester, scientific tester.
Oh, it's perfect.
Is it really?
Scientifically tested lukewarm water right there.
Cherry.
All right, so now.
I got my wooden spoon.
So now, anyways, we're getting rid of the spoon and we're gonna go with an actual hardwood stick. Because we think this is critical to the actual production. Here, let's get a close-up of this stick. Let's see this. As you can see, it's got about a 1-inch width, 1/4-inch wide, about 14 inches long. It's really critical that the stick matches these dimensions. It has a slight curve to it.
Yep, the slight curve is
slight curve.
Yeah, it's gonna be like curve. A little spoon effect.
That's right. So as you stir, it'll go straight.
Yeah.
So it won't break.
Oh.
It gives it some extra.
Rigidity?
Rigidity. Now,
All right, well, I think you just have to use your teeth.
I think I have to use my teeth.
Yeah, because...
Okay, you ready?
Do they have a...
All right, we're going to open this up. Now, this is definitely a two-person operation. So as I slowly add this in, we're going to stir. Look at the action he's got going on. Notice that he only goes counterclockwise. He's at about 60 revolutions per minute. Oh, clockwise.
But is it clockwise? Or because if I'm looking at it from the bottom?
Well, I think that you can only stir it clockwise for like 45 seconds, and then you have to shift the for 45 seconds.
What if we're in the southern hemisphere?
Well, then you go counterclockwise for 45 and then clockwise. Okay, the bag is, we have diminished the bag.
Dude, that looks like horchata.
Horchata.
That looks like horchata mix.
It kind of does look like horchata. I'm not sure the extent. It doesn't say how long you have to mix it for.
Good?
I don't know.
There's still a couple of chunks in
there.
Yeah,
I would still keep going. I think you're going to have to. Oh, we may need. Do you have a whisk? You got some buildup.
Dude. Oh, dude, that smells crazy. That smells like tamales or something.
It's corn.
It's corn.
Yeah, it's still lukewarm. It's still warm. But I'm just trying to get these little dough balls.
I am gonna, yeah. Thomas has retrieved the cloth that we're going to put to protect this from bugs and allow, if it does ferment, so we don't get any overflow.
That is not a lager.
That is not a lager. We should log the time right now. It is, let's say, 7:30.
Yeah, 7:30. And this is ready to be put away for Miley's birthday.
For Miley's birthday. And we would like to thank all of you for watching the video. Hopefully you've learned something. Things to do or not to do. But anyways. Ciao.
Hasta la vista, baby.